Tim Pierce. If you're a guitar player and you don't know him, I highly recommend you go follow him here on YouTube. Great channel, lots of good information, and you're getting this good information from a well-known LA session guy. And please subscribe to this channel if you aren't subscribed, and hit that notification bell so you can be notified the next time I put out a video. Last night, Tim did a gig at the Baked Potato, and he's released a couple of videos before last night's gig. One was talking about setting up a pedal board for this gig. Another one, he did a live stream, which I watched, where he was talking about, the note choices, scale choices he was using when it came to soloing and doing some improvisation over these songs. And I asked him on the live stream, because he talked about the pedals and all, but I didn't hear anything about the amp, so I wanted to know, what amp are you using? And he kindly responded to my question and said he was using his beloved Divided by 13 amp, because he loves that Divided by 13 amp. All right, now last night I'm at the show and I had to go sit in the back patio, so I wasn't actually in the same room with the band while Tim was playing. I just slacked on getting tickets early enough so I could be in the room, but it's okay. I was in the back patio, I was able to watch on the big screen the gig going on. And Tim sounded great. So, the whole band sounded good. Tim's tone was fantastic. It totally worked for it. And I enjoyed what he was playing. I enjoyed what all the guys were playing. And yet, there was no Divided by 13 amp. I didn't see a Divided by 13 amp head anywhere.
What?
There was a different amp on top of the speaker cabinets. Are you ready for this? Instead of a Divided by 13 amp, there was a Crate CPB150 power block, a solid state amplifier. So I was really just blown away by this because I thought he sounded pretty good, but I couldn't understand why the Divided by 13 amp wasn't there or any of his good amps. Because if you watch his channel, this guy's got a shitload of kick-ass amps. But here's a great power block on top of his two, I believe they were 1x12 cabinets. He had one stacked up on top of the other with this great power block on top. So after the first set, I went to talk to Tim. I said, hey, man, I wanted to ask you, I really expected to see your Divided by 13 amp. Here's what he told me. The Divided by 13 amp failed. It was like smoking. It just kind of blew up during sound check. Total disaster. Fortunately, someone had this Crate power block as an emergency backup, and Tim just had nothing. So he went ahead and went with the Crate power block instead, because at least he's able to play something. But Tim told me he was blown away at how good it sounded. He finished off the sound check with the Crate power block and he felt it sounded good. He was only embarrassed by how it looked. Like, here's this tiny little Crate power block on top of these nice speaker cabinets. So he's like, I don't know, should I still use it? It looks kind of silly, that little tiny power block. But he said he was still inspired to play. The sound was good. He felt that he still had a rich, warm tone that inspired him to play. And that's why I told him, man, that's all that matters. I thought it sounded pretty good. I thought you sounded great. But, how did you feel playing it? And it felt great. And it's sort of like, gosh, I told him, kind of makes me like rethink a lot of things when it comes to amps and tone. And I told him, dude, you should totally do a video on that. And so he says, yeah, I think that's a good idea. And I'm doing a video about it right now because this just blows my mind. This huge LA session guy for decades was using a solid state power amp, not because that was his first choice, but because he had to. His regular tube amp blew. And of course, as guitar players, you know that solid state amps are an absolute sin. Unless, of course, you're using the solid state amp for your modeler, like if you have an Axe FX, which has like some amp modeling and speaker cabinet modeling Typically, you can use a solid-state amplifier into some FR-FR speakers, that sort of thing for amp modeling, something like that, or a loaded-down amp with speaker cabinet simulation. Usually, that could be done with solid-state amps. But other than that, you would never have your pedal board with just pedals running into the solid-state amp. That would be a sin! You'd be kicked out of the Guitar Players Club! Tim told me that he uses drive pedals to get his tone. He has an always-on pedal that's set up for the edge of breakup. I didn't ask him which one he used for the edge of breakup. I can guess, but I'm not really sure which one he used, so, you know, that's my mistake. And then, of course, any other overdrive tones, he's just adding more drive pedals onto that always-on pedal, and then he has some effects on there as well. But this blew my mind and is really making me rethink a lot of things, because, of course, I love tube amps, and so does Tim. It's obvious. If you watch his channel, you can see this guy just has a whole bunch of classic tube amps all around him. And, you know, I have my Mesa Boogie Mark V 25. Here you go. Here it is. I have my Mesa Boogie Mark V 25 over here that I absolutely love. But when I'm going to use this thing playing out live, I will load it down with a load box and then go ahead and use a solid-state amplifier. So I'm not new to that. I do have a solid-state amplifier. I have a Matrix stereo solid-state amplifier. And I've used it a few times, but I've never really put it through its paces to really, really test this thing out. You really push the limits to see how close can I get to like a tube amp sound using that solid state amp. And I gotta tell you, I think I'm pretty convinced that solid state amps, even like a crate, can be really, really useful. You don't need tube power amps. Now, I know some of you guys are gonna say, no, no, there's no other way except tube power amps. But, you know, when you're out playing gigs, you know, a gig's a gig. You gotta do your gig. You gotta be inspired to play. And this just is really something to see someone like Tim Pierce be perfectly happy with a crate. A crate, not like a high quality solid state amp, like the Seymour Duncan Power Stage, from what I understand, is a pretty kick-ass solid state amp, but an old crate that they don't even make anymore was perfectly satisfactory for him. He was totally inspired to play, and I agree, I thought he sounded great. Let me know what you think in the comments, you guys. Have you considered using solid state amps? And when I say that, you know, have you tested this out by getting your tone from pedals rather than the tone from the amp? Let me know in the comments if you've gigged with solid state amps and how that's going for you. I think I'm gonna start, I am definitely gonna gig with the solid state amp. In my case though, I am still gonna use the Mesa Boogie amplifier. And so its power section, its preamp and power section is gonna be loaded down and then go to the solid state amp and some speaker cabinets. But what do you think, guys? I mean, is this just a new way to do it and get killer tones to use solid state amps? And you don't really necessarily need these heavy, big, bulky, tube power amps? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you guys. Thank you so much for watching. And again, Tim Pierce kind of blew my mind about this by accident. It wasn't intentional. So that makes it even more awesome. Please subscribe if you haven't. Hit that notification bell and I will talk to you guys soon.